What are you doing?
I'm just going to work in my place.
Oh, you're searching our own house for you? Why, you don't like this house?
Yes, this house is very dirty.
Okay, so where you want to go?
I want to go...
Smile House?
Yeah.
Where is that house?
That smiley house is on...
Bathroom?
On tent.
Tent? Where is that tent?
Tent is on there.
Then that is also this house only, no? This, you don't like this house, right?
I don't like this house.
Ah, so you have to take your tent also and go.
Yes.
Where you will go?
I like to take...
You're finding that place in computer. Mm-hmm. In laptop, you're finding the place to go. Which site are you referring?
The place. House.
Wow. You found a house. Where is that paradise?
The paradise is on outside.
Outside. So when are you shifting your luggage?
I'm shifting on smiley.
Smiley? No, no. When are you shifting?
I'm shifting tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Wow, wow. But tomorrow is your tiffin day in school. So you're not attending tiffin day?
Yes, I'm attending.
So you will make sandwich?
Yes, I'll make sandwich alone.
You'll make sandwich alone?
Yes, with the fire pit.
Fire? What and all you will add in sandwich, tell me.
I will add fruits, vegetables, tomato, onions, and kiwis.
Wow, that is a healthy breakfast. Yummy, yummy.
Yum.
Yum. Then what else will you do?
I will color some of the... I will color my house to make nice color. Nice
color. Oh, is it?
Yes.
What color do you like for your house?
Green color, right?
Halka.
I like yellow smiley.
Okay.
Now you can use.
So why are you leaving the house? Apart from being dirty, why are you leaving the house?
Because I'm coloring my beautiful house.
No, no, you said something, no? Acha has one room, Amma has one room, you don't have a room. That's why you are going, no?
I'm shifting.
You are shifting, okay, okay. No. Because you don't have a room.
No.
Okay, okay. So in that new house, you have only room for you, right?
I colored smiley.
Okay, smiley good, house. Good, good.
Now we have a tokens and a card, a vision card. We have a power chain.
Okay, so my turn now. We are about to reach the climax of the game. Okay, move plus 5 steps or otherwise move the opponent plus 4 steps. So if I move plus 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll go back 9 steps. Okay, let me try moving Puchku plus 4 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4!
Yeah!
Winner! Puchku!
Yeah!
First chance winner!
Yeah!
Puchku is the winner in the very first game.
So we'll
of
give you the start. Details about the game sometime later, that how we played and how we started all
beautiful,
these
Puchku, you are the winner.
But the first time Puchku has turned out to be the winner. Stay tuned. This is the Forest Run game. It's a very interesting game. Very nice game for kids.
Hi guys. So this is the latest game which we have bought for Puchku. Forest Run Adventure Games is actually for 7 plus year kid. And 2 to 4 players have to play. And it's half an hour plus game. So it's a very interesting game. Which was only four, but let me tell you that he won the first ever game which we played here. Me, Asha and Puchku played and he won the first game. So, we did the unboxing a while back and I'll just show you the board how it is. So, this is how the board is. So, we have the numbers from 1 to victory, which is 100. And then in between, you can see so many different kind of things shown. I'll explain you what is the meaning of those things and what exactly, you know, is the component of this game. So, first, we have this pile. This is called the game card pile. So, Puchku is holding few of the cards. So, this is where we have the different, you know, spells written and the different moves written. What you have to do after taking each card. So, once we start our game from number one. So, this is how one of the, you know, game cards will look like. So, say for example, this is the first move I'm going to do. Either move plus four steps or move opponent minus one step. So, that means... as a player, I can move 1, 2, 3, 4 steps, or if we are in the middle of the game, we can, instead of choosing for ourselves to move, we can move the opponent minus 1 step so that they can come back. So similarly, you know, we have so many game cards in this pile which says like this, move 2 steps for yourself or opponent minus 3. Sometimes it will be helpful for opponent also. You want to move your friend or the opponent a little bit ahead so you can help them as well. And then we have this
skip option also. You need to
skip skip based on the card you're getting. And then we have this magic spells, different kind of spells like energy,
different kind of spells,
rage, yes, Puchku, serenity, magic and diffuser. So each has a unique you know, benefit to it, or probably an advantage which you can use when you're in the game. So sometimes when you reach these places, like this is a spell. So you can see blue color inside a wand. So that is this magic. So you can collect a magic spell, which you can use later, and I'll tell you how to.
This one to cut.
Yes, Puchku. You how to use that. So similarly, we might land upon a different spell. Like this is the rage spell. This is the serenity spell, and this is the energy spell. So you know, you will end up landing here. And these are the resource tokens. So we have three different resources. One is fruit, one is firewood. Sorry, wood, and one is fire. So I'll tell you the relevance of it. So when you land here, you can collect one token of fruits. When if you land here, you can collect one token from wood. And if you land in such places, you can take one token of fire. So what is the use is, if you see the board, they have written each spell how to use. So if you have to use a rage spell, you should have three fire tokens. And if you have to use a serenity spell, you have to use two fruits and two woods. Similarly, if you have to do a magic spell, you have to use two fire and two fruits. If you have to use an energy spell, then three fruits. So, you know, if you have those many resources with you and if you have that spell card, you can cast that spell. That spell can be used for multiple purposes. Like the energy spell, for example, can be used for doubling a friend tile bonus. So what is a friend tile? Friend tile is something like this, which it is in the board itself and it allows you to move ahead. So like here, if you see it's plus 6, that means if you land here, you can go up to 6 places front. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in case you had an energy spell with you with all the resources, so if I cast that spell, that means instead of plus 6, I can go plus 12. And similarly, we do have a monster tile, which is opposite of friend tile, which is against you. So here, if you come, you have to go back minus 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 places back you have to come. So... in that case, what you can do is, you can use the cage spell. In case you have the cage spell and you have resources for the cage spell, use this spell to fight a monster. That means, if you cast a spell when you are landing here, you don't have to go back 7 steps and you can stay on this itself. If you use the cage spell. So similarly, there are different spells, different challenges, and this is a landmine. If you come here, you have to go back to number 1, or otherwise you have to use a diffuser spell, which can... make sure that you don't go back to 1 and you can stay there. So if you have landmine, you have different spells, you have different friend tiles, monster tiles and everything and resources. And finally, the person who reaches the 100, that is the victory first, will be the winner. And the very first game we played, the winner was none other than Puchku. Yes. So stay tuned, guys. And you can find the link in the description for this game. It's a very nice game. Go ahead and try it.